Overall, how are you feeling about this legislative session? What's happening that you like? Where are you concerned? There are lots of places that could blow up, yet there's a progressive agenda that, that you've supported that's moving along.
So I'm really pleased with the leadership and the presiding officers and our level of collaboration. I think the fact that the Medicaid, at least 50% of the Medicaid funding package is moving out of committee on Friday with the bipartisan, what we anticipate will be bipartisan support, is terrific. I don't remember this ever moving this early ever. And one of my staffers reminded me that in 2003, it didn't move till August. So I'd forgotten that, but I suspect a lot of what happened that year, those couple of years, I can't remember any nitty gritty details just because it was really challenging. I think the fact that we're working well together, stuff feels like it's moving pretty quickly, is good. I want to make sure that Republicans, folks representing rural communities, have an opportunity to have their voices be heard. I know that the Clean Energy Jobs Committee is now going out on the road. I don't know how extensively. I think they've got Bend and Medford, and I think that's a really good thing. And so I just think it's so important for people to stay engaged and stay at the table while legislation is moving forward.
What are you doing with Republicans to help them form your agenda and be part of the process?
So, honestly, we had a reception last week for rural legislators and rural leadership. I have to say, we got into a little bit of trouble in terms of how we defined rural, because I frankly didn't think of Representative Sherry Helt from Bend as rural, but she is. We invited her, and then we didn't invite some folks from the Valley who clearly represent rural communities. So at least we got the conversation. We were really focused on investments and how we can work together to ensure that at the very minimum, the investments I'm proposing get made, from the Wallawa Lake Dam to the Newburgh-Dundee right-of-way investments. So we've been really focused on funding and how we can work together around that. I am continuing to talk to Republicans based on a particular issue, but I think it's so important that they stay engaged and they stay at the table, because they can affect the way the train is going down the track, right? And so I liken it to when my stepdaughter wanted a dog, and I said no as the stepmom. Her dad said yes, and her mom said yes. Well, guess what happened? We got a dog, and the dog didn't really fit her needs or her lifestyle, and the story ended up very badly, to make a long story short. My lesson, my takeaway from that was when you see a train coming down the track, to get on that train and see if you can move it in your direction or in a way that you think makes more sense. And so next time when I know I'm going to get overruled, I'm going to like figure out how I get on the train and make sure that it meets the needs of the family or the situation. And that's what I'm encouraging Republicans to do.
A quick follow-up.
Wait, sorry. You have to finish the anecdote about how the dog story ended
the dog
up so badly.
Bit the police chief in Enterprise, and met its demise. So,
Dogs taken to the shelter and then put down or something?
Yes, pretty much.
Or gunfire by the police.
I don't know. I don't think it was gunfire. I'm sure it was put down. So.
A quick follow-up. although dog control is very important.
Yes, 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 yes.
What about...
Hillary.
What about community colleges, which are so important to Representative Health District and rural Oregon?
So I'm continuing to have conversations with legislative leadership and legislators about why I think it's so important to have community colleges and universities in the investment package. I think the co-chairs, and by that I mean as we talk about and hopefully achieve new revenue, additional revenue on the table, that community colleges and universities would benefit from that. And the reason why I am so committed to that is I see community colleges as absolutely instrumental for what is happening around workforce development. And every business, every employer that I talk to says continuing to hire skilled employees is a challenge. And it doesn't matter whether it's Hill Meats in Pendleton or frankly, Sabrina Parsons, Palo Alto Technology Software Company in Eugene, that employment and hiring folks with the skills they need is a challenge, and community colleges are absolutely part of that solution. They're also a great employer and a great partner in rural communities around the state. So I'm committed to getting them more resources. I think what there's not a sense in terms of the budget yet, in terms of the co-chairs and how much resources. I think they're going to be troubled in their base budget to provide the resources that the community colleges and the universities need to keep tuition rates down and make it affordable and accessible for students and to continue to open access for the Oregon Promise program. So,
could we talk about
that? Let's get